It is a heck of a fun time. I mean, you go out there and you just don't want it to end. I hope that we at least finish a race for once. That's my goal tonight.
You got it, Anna.
So this club was kind of a dream of my best friend and I. We decided, it'd be really cool if UNL had a race team.
Yeah, I can hold the wheel up.
Figure eight is a style of racing that takes place typically on a dirt track. As the name kind of suggests, it's a track that's in the shape of an eight or an infinity symbol. That presents a very interesting engineering problem for students to solve. It's like, how do they make a car that is strong enough to withstand hits to the side or something like that, or hits to the back where it won't cave in?
You want me to get a pick?
It's been really nice to be able to work on something that I never had an opportunity to. And the more and more I'm with the club and the more I dig into the project, the more invested I get, which makes me want to do more and more. So I'm working on this car with these guys. And then hopefully when the next project comes in, I can work more on that car and then another car after that.
So this is my first time here. To be honest, I walked through the door and I really didn't know what to expect. I didn't even know what car they were racing. So all I knew that they did was figure eight. So I figured I'd just come in and check it out and see what they did.
So you're doing more.
One of our hopes for the club was that we'd be able to bring in engineers that didn't have any experience with cars or automobiles at all and teach them. So it's like, so they understood when they get out in the field someday, okay, this is what life for a welder or a manufacturer looks like after they pass on their designs. We wanted the engineers graduating from Nebraska to understand both sides of that coin.
We've had quite a few problems. I think this is our third motor. So obviously many car guys know there's always issues and you're always going to find something wrong. We're finding those.
No.
That's
yeah,
where
no.
It's supposed to be, actually.
Would you like?
We're going to be racing against people that have, you know, probably 20, 30,000 sunk into their cars, and we're working with like easily under 10
and
hopes and dreams.
All of our races happen in Nebraska. Most racers are from Nebraska. But because of that, we won't be going up against other universities. We'll be going up against just private citizens, I guess, is the best way to put it.
Obviously, this is the first year. Not a whole lot of people here right now. It's so easy to come in and fill a role. Things aren't really set in stone, so there's a lot of play in things and how things can be done or should be done. And so it's very enjoyable to be able to come in here, help out with those things.
So figure eight is a really good example of what we're trying to do here and kind of at the start of a new era. We want to make sure that people have the opportunity to try these new things out. We want to give the literal space as well as the tools and the equipment for students to work on their projects. Hewitt Hall and the College of Engineering is really built on empowering students to come up with big ideas and execute on those big ideas.
I'm like, this seems like a lot of fun. I work on my own car, so I'd get experience working on a car that does get hit, gets like maintenance that would need regularly.
Yep.
I'm like, this is a good experience for me
to turn the engine manually.
I think this just goes to show what Nebraska offers here, and I think this is a great opportunity, and we thank everyone here in Nebraska who's made it possible, and I hope things like this can continue growing and there's more opportunities like this in the future.
So Aaron,
yeah?
If today doesn't pan out, don't put any of this in the video.
Oh,
showed up, we needed to weld the doors on because our welder stopped working. We got it all set up out there to go run it. And we got it out there running it on the first turn. The battery shorted out and we lost all power.
Problems for Herbie Husker already? Shaking his head.
Even though it didn't go as planned, I think we definitely got good attention out of it. We got people that are happy to see some college coming out here and doing a sport that doesn't have any like college support in it.
We'll get you pushed out. You have to come back for a comp.
Okay.
All right, go work on it.
Okay, thank you.
We're gonna go watch some races, see the competition, see what we've got going on out there, and see what our next plan of action is.
Felt good. I was out there doing just fine. We ended up hitting the rear end of one guy and car just shut off dead. Sounds like a fuel line came off and then a spark plug wire. Slower on trying to get things back, figuring out, diagnosing things. This race, we knew what it was like that, fixed it, and we're able to get back. That's something that takes a lot of teams years to figure out. So the fact that we were able to diagnose, fix, and be ready for the next race was amazing. This track is so small and wet, you have to be able to kick your back end out, which we can't do without power steering real well. And with our wheels bent in, it takes a lot more oomph to get that wheel turned.
We came into this, we're like, haven't finished a race yet, so this is the goal is to finish it. Also break it in. Everyone was worried it looked so good. Now it looks
doesn't
like a car,
look yeah, it doesn't car. Look so good.
And it wasn't lapped.
Yeah.
That's all that matters. The nice part about having this many races is you quickly learn the car, the track, and how to drive. And it helps out our crew too, because it's all that design process and figuring out how to change things quickly and then be able to design for the next race. Other clubs don't get that experience and just have to go out, run one race, and figure out what's wrong. We have a week now to fix it, try again.
Honestly, I think it comes up to we've been in the same shop so much and we've all spent so many hours together that at this point we're getting to be more of a, an oiled machine. We might not be well oiled by this point, but we're getting there.
What's next?
I think next goal is beating somebody and winning the race, right?